From India, from Mumbai or wherever, from whichever part of India. So let's get back. So I'll just repeat a little bit what we did last time, last Friday. So we learned about the energy system, how does it work in the body. Then we learned about the square breathing with Gayatri Mantra, which is a very powerful breathing technique, come meditation. And when you do it really changes things, because normally what happened, we do very shallow breathing. So on an average, a human being can be alive without eating food for 15 days. Without water, a human being can survive for 3 days. Without air or without breath, we can't survive more than 3 minutes. That too with proper practice. So breathing is so important. And so on that day, we learned the technicality of the breathing, deep breathing practice, and how to hold that. So I told you all on that day. And as it is, Gayatri Mantra is a wonderful mantra. It has been created, and each and every mantra has a lot of power. And Gayatri Mantra is a combination of 24 mantras. And when you chant this mantra, or when you're in a vicinity where the chanting is happening, and along with that, if you're doing breathing process also, 24 tattvas or principles of our body or elements of our body get vibrated, stimulated, and get balanced. I spoke about all those 24 elements. So they are five elements, that is tattvas. Earth, water, fire, air, and ether. Then five pranas that I told you all on that day, that the prana, the energy flow in our body, and they flow in different directions. So different directions have been given name. So they are pran, apan, udan, saman, and vyan. You must have heard, Hindus must have heard it so many places, because whenever we do havan, we do mention these names. Okay, and then five sense organ, that is eyes, nose, ears, your tongue, and your skin. Then five work organ, that is hands, legs, genital areas, anus, and again your tongue and mouth, sorry, and man, chit, ahankar, and buddhi. So man is our lower mind, the conscious mind. We are the slave of this mind, let's say that. And it's very limited. I explained on that day. And buddhi is an intellect mind. And we want to get connected to our intellect mind. That is our buddhi. And chit is our self, the jiva, which you can't say, like Shankaracharya, you must have heard that, who are you? So I am Satchidanand Brahma. That's what I am. That's what chit I am talking about. And ahankar. We are again slave of ahankar. So these are the 24 elements. When you chant Gayatri Mantra, or you are doing square breathing with Gayatri Mantra, you work upon all these 24 elements. And we learn the method how to do it. Today we will talk about the prana once again. So on that day, I told you all that the prana flows in our body through channels. And those channels are termed as nadis. Any guess how many channels are there in the body? We have 72,000 channels in the body. And out of those 72,000 channels through which the prana flows, prana operate and control everything in our body, our thought process, our each and every organ or part of the cell, and everything in our body, prana controls. Okay? And out of those 72,000, imagine, prana, obviously we cannot see it. And even these nadis are very subtle. You cannot see these nadis. Again, don't worry, I will share all the videos with all of you. You cannot see all these nadis. They are subtle, yet you can feel them. You can experience them. And the number of that is 72,000. And out of those 72,000 channels, 10 are believed to be important. So let's talk about what are those 10 important nadis in our body. Just give me a minute. I'm really bad in this.
To understand chakras, they must first...
I guess we cannot see. Let's to start with you. Can anyone,
see this? Nadis can be explained as channels through which the primordial energy of prana flows.
We don't see the video. I think it didn't double click.
As it governs the functioning of the mental and physical needs of our existence.
Yeah, I lost myself.
You can stop sharing and start again.
Okay. No, let it be because I'm unable to do that. I don't know why. Okay, let me see this.
Try one more.
Yeah. Now, is
to
it,
understand chakras, we must first understand nadis.
You didn't click the share button.
Channels through which the primordial energy or prana flows. As it governs the functioning of the mental and physical planes of our existence.
Okay. So as I told you all about this, and I'm not at all...
So if you are not showing video, this, you can stop sharing and again share.
I'll stop sharing because it's much better to talk like this. Okay. Anyway, so out of those 72,000 channels, what I just showed you, 10 are believed to be important. And those 10 are connected with our gates of the body. And not what are those gates? Those gates are your anus. Okay, your urinary tract, then your mouth, two nostrils, two eyes, two ears. And the last one, the most important one, is the Brahmarantra, that is the top of your head, the crown of your head. And I've taken many workshops. And do you know, like a person, a human being dies from many one or two gates? And from whichever gate the person dies, reveals the kind of he or she, the kind of person he or she was, and the kind of life the person has led. Yes, you are hearing me rightly. So it reveals. So we have two lower gates, that is your anus and urinary tract. And what happened? How do you come to know that the person has died from there? They soiled their clothes just before their death. That means if they pass urine just before their death, that means they have died from the urinary tract. And if they die from the anus, they soil their clothes, they pass stool. And mouth remains open. The nostril, you don't come to know. At times, there's a trickle of blood or nothing else because it's a form of subtle prana, which cannot be seen. Then ears, you cannot, you don't come to know. Eyes remain open. That means a person has died from the eyes. And this, do you know what happens? It cracks. Yes. So people who die from these seven gates, that is two eyes, two ears, two nostrils, and one mouth, such kind of people are called more rajasic. So tamasic people, normally, if you get to see, they die from the lower gates, that is your anus or urinary tract. So such kind of people, live a very tamasic life, you know, full of anger, jealousy, lethargyness, cruelty, I won't say inhuman, but they are not helpful or they are not very kind. And Rajasic and Sattvic gun is very less in them in degree. These Rajasic, they are not as bad as Tamasic, yet they have both the both the gunas, that is Sattvic, very good quality, and even some of the quantity of Tamasic. So Tamasic person suffer from or has, all of us, we have six vices, and these six vices always travel in pair. It's called Sadariku. And what is Sadariku? It's called Mohmaya, Kam Krodh, Isha Ahankar. So Kam Krodh is desire and anger. So what is desire and anger? Whenever our desire, as I said, that they always travel in pair. Whenever our desire doesn't get fulfilled, we get angry. Okay? Then Isha Ahankar. Suppose two people have the same capability and capacity and ability and intelligence, yet one person, Mr. A, becomes more famous. So if Mr. B's ego gets hurt, so Isha Ahankar, ego gets hurt, so he gets jealous of Mr. A. Okay, so that's how the pairing happens. And Mohmaya, that is attachment and greed. Whenever we are attached to certain things, we can become more greedy. So a tamasic person has these six vices in higher degree. A rajasic person has these six vices in lower than tamasic people. And sattvic people who die from here doesn't have or has these six vices next to very less or almost like a nil, not at all, completely not at all. So you will be surprised. I must be having more than 10,000 students now. And whenever I take this workshop, I always ask, do you know anyone who has died from here? And so far, out of 10,000, so you can see the number, the ratio, only 32 so far have told me, yes, I know a person who has died from here. Some said my father, some said my grandfather, some said my guru, my teacher, some said my mother, and one of them said my Maharaj, he died. And I asked them, like, can you describe the kind of people they were or the kind of life they led? And all 32 people's answer was same. All of them, they said, oh, they were saint-like. They were very helpful, very kind, very lovable. And they never used to differentiate among people. They simply used to help, love, and take care of everyone, whoever came in around them. They used to help everyone. So, sattvic people die from here. And such kind of people get enlightened. That's what I wanted to tell you. Now, out of these 10 nadis, as I said, out of 72,000 nadis or channels, 10 are believed to be important. And out of these 10, 3 are again most important. Those 3 are called Ida Nadi or Chandra Nadi or Moon Channel, Pingla Nadi or Sun Channel, and Sushumna Nadi or Central Channel. So, you can check it out. Whenever we breathe in and out predominantly through the left nostril at that time, remember, predominantly through the left nostril at that time, our Ida Nadi or the left channel is more, is active. Okay? And whenever we breathe in and out through the right nostril at that time, Pingla Nadi or the right channel is more predominant. That nadi is active. And whenever, so whoever goes for a walk or yoga, you must have seen that after your exercise or walk and all, what is your mental condition? You must be feeling very energetic, happy, and full of confidence. So when that happens, that means you start breathing in and out equally through both the nostrils. When that happens, your central channel, that is your Sushumna Nadi, gets activated. This activization of these three nadis, Ida, Pingala, Sushumna, or left, right, and central, is called Swar Yoga. And when you learn to control these the actions or activization of these channels, actually a lot of your problems will be solved. In fact, during this COVID-19 or corona disease, this is very, very helpful, because through these three channels, you learn to control your prana inside. You know, your breathing. Breathing is the tool, it's a medium which connects your inner body with the outer body. And there's nothing else which can connect. So the moment you start concentrating, you're focusing on your breath, you automatically can get connected to your inner self. So, and plus, these Ida and Pingala, they are connected with your left and right brain. You know that? We have two brains, left and right. So whenever you are breathing in and out through the left channel, your right brain gets activated. Whenever you are breathing in and out through the right nostril, your left brain gets activated. And they are connected with so many things. So your left brain and the right nostril is connected with your physical activity, and your right brain and left nostril is connected with your mental activity. And whenever you start breathing in and out equally through both the nostrils, your both brain, there is complete harmony between both your brains, and both brain is active at the same time. Isn't it the wonderful position when both your brains get activated? And after every, remember, after every 90 to 120 minutes, this change happens. It's pure science. Like how we get night and day. And these Ida and Pingala are known as Qi and Qi in Chinese. Qi and Qi. Okay? So remember that. And they are Ida and Pingala, left and right, north and south pole. That's what it is. That's how our body is also connected with. Yatha Prinde Tatha Brahmastre means our body is a mini universe. So whatever exists in this huge universe, our body also has in a miniature form. So our body has sun, moon, everything our body has. Ocean, sun, moon, river, planets, and you name it, and our body has in a miniature form. Okay? So I'll share a few tips about this. You know, very easily you can control this activization. So if you eat the moment you have your lunch or dinner or your meal, whatever, immediately you can check it out. And how will you check it out? You'll do a pranam mudra, place your hand on your upper lip and breathe out forcefully. So whichever side you feel the breath, that nadi or that channel is active at that time. Okay? Now, two, three things. Whenever you'll have any meal, your right nostril automatically gets activated. It has to get activated. If it doesn't, that means you're suffering from indigestion. Okay? And you can tell, it can amuse any person, because that has to happen. Like how there is day and night, it has to happen. Okay, and your left brain controls the function of your entire body. And what does the left brain does? Left brain create heat in the body. It so that you can digest your food. That's the reason after having your meal, if you want to take nap during the daytime, people say, or the yogis always say, to sleep on your left side. Now, why that? Because when you sleep on your left side, your right nostril is up, and that automatically gets activated. You start breathing in and out through the right nostril. That helps to digest your food. Okay? Now, whenever you get angry, remember that you'll be breathing in and out through the right nostril only. Through the right nostril only. So if you obviously, so many times we can't show our anger. We have to control it. How do you control it? So you just close your right nostril for 2 to 5 minutes. The moment your left nostril gets activated, your anger will disappear without harming you or the others. Fine. If you are feeling a very mild fever, again, your right nostril will be active. So if you want to get rid of it, and you do, obviously you feel lethargy at that time. So you again close your right nostril. The moment your left nostril gets activated, because left nostril cools down your body and it controls your mental activity. So the moment your left nostril gets activated, your mild fever will disappear. Now, if you're feeling lethargy, at that time your left nostril will be active. And you want to feel, you have so much of work to do and you're feeling lethargy, you don't feel like doing anything. So at that time, close your left nostril. The moment your right nostril gets activated, your lethargy will go away. Okay, you'll be active once again. Now, in case of headache, whichever nostril is active, most of the time it will be your left nostril. Close that nostril. The moment your other nostril gets activated, your headache will disappear. Remember that without popping in your pill, you can get rid of your headache. So there are many more like that, but let's move ahead. And through pranayama, as I said, that our breath is the medium to... a medium or the tool through which you get connected with your internal body. So your external body, that your entire body, internal body can be connected only through breath. And now prana also can be controlled with the help of breathing. So what is pranayama? You must be hearing this word of yoga. Pranayama, what does that mean? What do you do in this? It's a breathing exercise, yes. But the meaning is hidden in this. So break this word, pran plus ayam. Pran means energy. Ayam means exercise. So exercise of prana is pranayam. And how do you give exercise to your prana? With the help of your breath. So today we will be talking about 4 important pranayams. And now what are those? Omkar, Bhramari, Anulom Vilom, and square breathing I've already taught you. So we will learn 3 important pranayams. But along with learning it, why you should do it, what are the effects, and how does it help you? That we need to learn. Okay? So very first one is Omkar. Omkar is chanting Om. Om itself, when you chant it for a number of times, it's itself a wonderful form of meditation come pranayama. Just like square breathing with Gayatri Mantra. You can chant it for 108 times and you can see the result. Because what is the result? Understand that. Om, it is a combination of 3 sound vibrations. Remember that. Combination of 3 sound vibration. And now what are they? A, U, Ma. Om. A, U, Ma. The beginning of Omkar, when you chant, what happens? It vibrates your entire spine and the lower body, your stomach and your chest. And along with that, your spine. Now, the center, the middle part of Omkar, that is U, stimulate your neck region. We have thyroid, we have parathyroid, we have our speech, the vocal gland, all get stimulated by chanting this. And we have our cervical spine. And Ma, the last part of Omkar, Om, Ma vibrates your entire head region. Now we have our pituitary gland, pineal gland, mammary bank, hypothalamus gland. We have thousands of nerves here. All of them, they get vibrated by chanting Om. Now, what do you have to do? How do you chant it? Not loudly. You have to feel the depth. You have to feel the vibration inside. Fine? And you have to focus where the sound is traveling from one part to the other part. Your focus should be on your breath, on the prana, and how the sound is traveling in your body. Fine? And now how do you chant it? Just watch me first, and then you can do it along with me just twice so that you will know how to do it when we do a little longer meditation, kam pranayama. So how will you do it? You will again sit in Gyan Mudra, touching your index finger with your thumb, and place both your hands on your lap. You have to breathe in deeply, and then while breathing out, you have to chant Om. Just see. Let's do it again. Let's do it three more rounds so you will know exactly what I'm talking about. And at the same time, when you're doing it, please focus on your body and the sound, traveling of the sound. Okay? Let's do it. Come on. Sit in your sit in the position. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Again. Last time. Now rub your palms, cup your eyes, and slowly open your eyes. Isn't it wonderful? As it is, you can feel yourself connected with your inner body, your outer body with your inner body. The next pranayama after Omkar is Brahmari. You all must have done Omkar, but knowing the benefits of Omkar is more important. Now, what are the benefits of Omkar? We have all our, the next Friday I'll be talking about all the chakras and the location. But all the main energy centers, which are known as the chakras, are located along your spine. Your body, your mind controls the action and reaction and everything. And your thought process is controlled by your mind with the help of your spine and spinal cord. And when you chant Om, your entire spine, your spinal cord, all your chakras get stimulated, all your energy centers, along with all the glands that are located inside. Your parathyroid, thyroid gland, your pituitary, pineal gland, all these glands get activated and it calms down your mind. It takes away your stress. It increases your memory. Yeah, that's what happens. So you can actually, now, how do you make a child? How do you install these value system in a kid? If you teach only Omkar to the kid, they'll be able to do it to a 3-year-old child and along with that. And see their intelligence, intellect then. See their intelligence level. Once they start doing it on a regular basis. And it's a wonderful way of introducing kids to yoga and pranayama. Okay? Next is Brahmari. Now, how do you do that? And then I will talk about the benefits. You can either do it with this way. You must have learned it. A lot of you must have learned it. Or, again, you can sit with both your hands in your lap. And you have to take deep breath. and keeping your mouth closed, you have to chant ma. The sound will be just like a bumblebee. How the bumblebee sounds, the sound is just like that. And how do you have to do? Just see. So, and keeping your mouth closed, your teeth should be azar. Otherwise, you'll feel vibration in your teeth, which you don't want. And your tongue should be touching your upper palate. Okay? And you have to chant ma. How do you do this? Again, like this. So I'm not doing this. But if you're comfortable, you can do that. Take that position or mudra also. And again. Last time. Rub your palms. Cup your eyes. Slowly open your eyes. Now, where do you think the vibration was? It vibrated your entire head region. So again, I'll repeat. We have pituitary gland, pineal gland, hypothalamus. Then you have memory bank, which is located here. So many nerves. So when you chant Brahmari, all those glands, and they get stimulated. All your nerves get relaxed completely. People suffering from vertigo should practice this, because this pranayama takes care of the earache also. And people who are suffering from insomnia should practice this morning and evening. Empty stomach, remember that. All the pranayama should be practiced empty stomach, or at least give a 3 hours break after your meal and then practice it. So people suffering from insomnia, they start getting quality sleep, and memory increases. So the kids also can learn this in a playful manner. You can teach it and show them how to do it, and some wonderful technique to do it. And it really gets you into a very deep and quality sleep. That's what it does. So this is the second important pranayama that is I'm talking about. The last one is Anulom Vilom. Again, you must have heard about it. Now, what do you do it? In that, you are activating both your nostril, and you're purifying both the nostrils or both channels, or you can say both brains, you're working on it. By doing that, you start activating your central channel, and that gets activated, and it start creating harmony between both your left brain and the right brain. But that's what it does. Now, how will we do it? So your left hand will remain in Gyan Mudra on your lap. Your right hand, that you have to practice, you have to control your breathing process of your left and right nostril with the help of your right hand. Remember, there is a science behind it. Never with your left hand, never like this. It has to be done in a proper mudra crawl called Prana Mudra. What do you have to do in that? Make a fist, open the last two fingers and the thumb, and then place it on your nostril, on your nose. And with the thumb, you will control the breathing process of your right nostril. With the help of these two fingers, you will control the breath or inhalation and exhalation of your left nostril. Okay? And then So whenever I say, and either you can keep both your fingers, if you can't fold it like this, you can keep it here and you can control, or you can fold it and you can control. Okay. So I will, though the right ratio of anulom vilom is 1:4:2, but right now, since quite a lot of you must be a beginner, so we will do, for 5 count, we will breathe in through the left nostril. You always start through the left nostril only. Okay. So you will breathe in through the left nostril. Hold like this. So you will control, stop the breathing in or breathing out by closing both the nostril. And when for 7 count. And breathe out will be through the right nostril for 6 count. Then again, breathe in through the left right nostril for 5 count. Hold again for 7 count. Breathe out again for 6 count through your left nostril. So you're doing it alternately. You're breathing in through one nostril, holding. Breathing out through the other nostril. And breathing in again through that nostril, hold. And breathe out through the left nostril. This becomes one round. So in, hold, out. In, hold, out is one round. And that way we will practice for 3 round. But now I'll just make you do 2 rounds so that you will know exactly how to do it. So again, sit with your eyes closed. Left hand in Gyan Mudra, right hand in Pranam Mudra. Place it on your nostril, nose, and control your breathing process. You can keep your eyes closed. You don't have to look at me. You just have to hear me out and control your breathing process. Okay? Begin. Left in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Left in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now rub your palms. Slowly cup your eyes. And now slowly open your eyes. A few of you must have already started breathing in and out equally through both the nostrils. You can check it out. Or the later on, once we do all the meditation, then you can check it out. And it's a wonderful technique because, again, it calms down. Now, 2-3 benefits that it does. A, it purifies your Ira Nadi, Pingala Nadi. Gives power to the central channel, that your Sushumna Nadi. And by doing that, what happens? You get connected to your intellect mind. Normally, as I said last time, that on an average, a human being utilizes only 5-7% of the brain capacity. Rest, 93-95% of the brain capacity remain untapped, unutilized. By doing anulom vilom, omkar, and brahmari, what happened? You get connected to that 95-93% of the brain capacity. Because the moment you start breathing in and out equally through both the nostrils, what happened? Automatically you start tapping and activating both the mind, actually activates your intellect mind. So a lot of people, or the yogis and all, they wait, because as I said, after every 90-120 minutes, whenever the change is happening from left to right or right to left, for a few moments you start breathing in and out equally through both the nostrils, only for a few moments. But people who does regular pranayama meditation, this few minutes changes into minutes. And at times, the enlightened people or the evolved people, it changes into hours and hours. And obviously, when that happens, they remain calm, serene, happy, kind, very helpful. They are the saint-like people who can actually activate, keep their prana in the upward position, traveling upward through the Sushumna, the central channel, and their brain is activated. They can create miracles. So miracle is all of us, we have the ability to do it, but we are ignorant towards that. We don't know how to do it. That's what happens. We are unaware of our own potential. Yes, friends, that's what it does. Very sad, yeah, but we are simply ignored. We utilize only 5 to 7% of the brain capacity. So imagine, by doing meditation, pranayama every day, we get connected to the higher intellect mind. When that happens, there'll be no negativity, no negative thought. You'll be very positive all the time. You'll be happy all the time. And regularly, people who do pranayama regularly, including anulom vilom, doesn't fall sick. Headache doesn't happen. They don't get it. It's true. It's a fact. People who do it, you can ask them. They don't suffer from cold and cough. Yes. Sinusitis problem and all. Either they don't get it, or whenever they get it, it doesn't last for a longer time. They get rid of it very soon. By abusing their body, whenever they get it, it gets cured very well. They get cured very fast. So obviously, they remain healthy. There is no stress. So the aging process also lowers down. Even that slows down. So many advantage. Have to know what are the good things. And during this time, when we are suffering from corona, it's everywhere. This is a must. These three pranayama are a must, along with square breathing and Gayatri Mantra. So I have taught you about all these three pranayama. Now, we will be doing 11 minutes of these wonderful four pranayama, including square breathing with Gayatri Mantra. But before that, if you have any question, let's answer that. Or you want to ask me after the session? Vipinji?
Couple of questions. One is, you mentioned empty stomach. Somebody asked, why on empty stomach?
Because why empty stomach? Because whenever we do any kind of pranayama or meditation and all, it slows down all your process in the body. So if you do it full stomach, A, you will not be able to do it properly. And B, it will hamper your digestion system. So you should never do it. And it will harm you more than you getting benefit from.
Another question was, if a person, you mentioned about, prana leaving through those different channels. So somebody asked, if a person dies of heart attack, then which prana?
So heart attack, again, the prana leaves from any one of the gate. Heart attack, people also can be tamasic, rajasic or sattvic. So heart people suffering from heart attack either can leave from the lower gates or these gates. That's what happens.
I think these are, why rubbing of hands after Om and Bhamdi?
Because our hands, this Gyan Mudra, we have 1-2 minutes. We have Gyan Mudra, right? Why do I always ask you to do that? All the time, our pores of the body, and especially the tips of our fingers, keep emitting the precious energy. That's the reason during winters, you must have experienced static, isn't it? So where does that static comes? That current in your clothes or in your comb or the surface or your bed, whenever you touch, you feel that current. How do you get it? It's your own energy which gets trapped. we keep emitting, we keep losing that precious energy. When you do meditation, pranayama, what happens? The blockages that you start creating in your nadis, those 72,000 nadis, which the prana flows through in our body, if you block 5 to 10,000 of the nadis, yet your body functions, but with lots of aches, pains, or diseases. Because each and every disease that we suffer from is because of the blockages of that, those nadis. And if the nadi along your, pancreas, if the nadis get blocked due to hereditary problem, what happened? Our nadis around your pancreas are already vulnerable. And due to too much of stress or bad eating habits or bad posture, what happened? Those nadis get, because of too much of stress, those nadis get start blocking or getting blocked. And when that blockages remain for a longer time, you start suffering from diabetes. That same thing happens for each and every disease, whether it's a small headache or the high other problem, the heart problem and all, or kidney problem. It's all related to your nadi block related diseases. Now, when you do meditation and pranayama, you don't want to miss out that precious energy. You don't want that to leave your body and go, because the blockages are opening up. That's a doctor today, nowadays, they say, okay, I am giving you, I'm doing the open heart surgery, but after that, you have to change your lifestyle. You have to incorporate pranayama, you have to incorporate yoga, you have to incorporate daily walks, and a lot of other alternate medical therapy. They say that. Why? To take care of these problems, because only medicine is not the answer. And when you sit in this mudra, what happened? The energy again start rotating inside. It doesn't leave your body by doing this. That's the reason I say always sit in gyan. So it's called gyan dhyan mudra. Okay? And that's what answers. So the person can leave from any of the gates.
So why do we rub the hands and put them on our eyes?
So when you rub, as I said, your paws, your hands, all the nerve ending happens over here. So by doing any of the pranayama, when you rub, so the effect of that pranayama and all, you want to give it to your face. And that rubbing, actually, all those energy gets collected here and then you give it back to your body.
We have another question about, is there a sequence to all these four types of pranayama that you are talking about?
I'll be share the audio the audio track with you all. So we will start with the Omkar, then Brahmari, then Anulom Vilom, and then square breathing with Gayatri. That's a sequence.
There's also a question about how do we get your presentation to listen another time, so that we understand it well.
Again, Ravi, I will share the videos with you. And whoever wants it, you can share those small videos to them. So if they have any query, they can see. And yet, if they have any query, you can share my email ID and they can ask me the question.
Or they can send it to chakradhyanahouston@gmail.com.
Yes, they can. They can send it. Yes, definitely.
There is also a question about, I have really bad digestion problems, chronic constipation, which causes the opposite, severe diarrhea. Can this be solved through breathing?
Swar yoga, as I said, that when you do swar yoga, that is controlling your prana through your of your nostrils. Again, whenever you need your right nostril to be active, or just after consuming your food, when you actually see that if that is not working, you can do that. And whenever, after every 90 to 120 minutes, that has to change to the left nostril. So that change has to constantly be done And by doing it every day, you will see a change in your digestion problem also, digestion system also.
Looks like that's all the questions we have for today. Mm-hmm. How many rounds is recommended for each is a question.
How long should we do pranayam every day? That's
minimum 11 minutes to get full benefit. So I'll be today we will be doing 11 minutes of track, the audio track. So that's what is important.
I think let's start that because we are on the just 9 minutes left. So let's start there.
So yeah, we will be little, it'll go 2-3 minutes above. So is that okay?
That's perfectly fine. Because questions will never end. I can, with your presentation, 1,000 questions.
Okay.
Thank you so much for this.
We'll have more sessions.
Because I wanted to share one more Nasika Drishti. That's again an important thing. But I guess next Friday, I will take up that. That's a wonderful pre-meditative posture. And it's very powerful again. But next. So. So do tell me the sound. Is it okay?
Take your positions. Sit with your back straight.
Is it okay with everyone? Is it audible?
It is audible.
Thank you.
Close your eyes and relax. Relax every part of your body. Let's begin with Omkar. Begin. Now, Brahmari. Prepare yourself for Anulom Vilom. Assume the pranamudra with your right hand and begin. Left in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Left in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Left in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold Jalandhar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Release. Gently bring your right hand back to Gyan Mudra. It is now time for square breathing in sync with the Gayatri Mantra.
Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात् ॐ भूर्भुवस्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात् ॐ भूर्भुवस्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात् ॐ भूर्भुवस्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात् ॐ भूर्भुवस्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्
Rub your palms, cup your eyes, and slowly open your eyes. Hari. So this track I will share with you, and till next Friday you can practice your pranayama meditation with the help of this audio track. I'll share it with Ravi and Ravi can share with all of you, or I will put it on this group. I've already put it earlier, but I will put it again, so you'll be able to see it. And that's it. So, and now Vipinji, you can, or Ravi.
Thank you so much, Pitiji. Thank you so much, really. And thank you to everyone, all participants, and a few thanks to Raviji for bringing it to with the India House for the benefit of everyone, and Manav for all your technical support. Thank you, everyone, and we'll close the session now. Thank you. Have a safe day, and safe evening, safe night, safe afternoon, wherever you are.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you. Have a good day. See you all next week again.